guys, so today I got a question from a high school coach, and it prompted me to respond trying to explain a drill to him by typing it out, and I realized as I was typing it, I wasn't doing a very good job explaining it, and this is a drill that I've tried to explain before by typing, and I'm not really any good at it. It's a very simple drill, but I figured I would send him a video to show him, and I realized if I was going to do that, I might as well just put it on here because it's a question that I get asked a lot by different athletes and coaches, and it's about the timing of the plant and just making sure the hands and the plant are consistent every time. And obviously, I'm not perfect at that yet, but it's helped me. A drill that's helped me make that a lot more consistent, and is pretty much one of the only drills that I do. It's called the and one drill. Now, this is of course a drill that Brad taught me. I can't really take any credit for anything that I preach, but it's something that's helped me immensely, and I do before all jump sessions, whether it's practice or competition. And so it's called the and one drill, or I call it that because I count my steps down. It's the last two steps in the run, and so it's the second last step or the penultimate step, and the one step is the takeoff step. So you start by holding the pole just like normal, with your top hand right at your hip. So for me, that's my right hand, and my bottom hand right in front of my chest. And I'm usually gripping about halfway down a pole. You need just a small, really light pole. Stubby is perfect. And so for that and step, that second last step, you're bringing that bottom hand right to the shoulder. So it's just one unit, one motion. That's and then one is just straight up in the air. So it's just and one. And I'm sure you've seen variations of this from different vaulters. But yeah, that's pretty much the drill that I do consistently. And it's something that's just really helped my timing in the plant coming into the takeoff. I'll do it from three lefts. I'll do it walking. I'll do it running and still counting the same way. And it's just really helped to make that consistent. So yeah, I hope that makes sense.